founder global chairperson of All and WEF, and a founder president of Wiki and Shri Gandhi. She is known for her leadership and exemplary work on women empowerment. Over to Dr. Arora.
Thank you so much, my dear soul sister Manjula, Rajiv ji, and our esteemed Dr. Kiran Bedi, our most beloved Dr. Kiran, Honorable Lieutenant Governor of Puducherry. Ma'am, before you came in, I was just telling everybody, you are our lucky mascot. I say that with a reason, because when we were launching All Ladies League, the first network we launched in around 2011 or 12, around that time, you were at the launch at the ASSOCHAM house with us. When we launched the first edition of the Women Economic Forum in Goa, you were with us. And now, few months after the launch of the Women's Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, you are again with us. Really, this is we have grown exceeding, and I feel somewhere your positive energy, the immense inspiration you bring with just your presence and you. Ma'am, you are legendary in history, but more than that, you occupy an eternal space in the hearts of women of this country, and for that we are eternally, eternally grateful. Just like you have opened when you were in Bihar, you made it, instead of a prison, you made it an ashram. You opened the place to the hearts and minds of the people. Just like in the same way you are in Puducherry and you made Raj Nivas the people's Nivas, you opened the gates of hallowed precincts of the governor's house to the people. In exactly the same inspirational way, our mission and vision at the Women's Indian Chamber is to open the hearts and minds of our nation, of our government, of our country, to the hearts and minds of women of this country, which is 50% of our population, however grossly underrepresented in positions of decision making. We have 154 councils in different sectors, including sports and prison reforms, inspired precisely by the focus you have put on those sectors, and the eastern region, which is led by Manjula ji and Indu ji, is the most exceptional regional council with so many different sectors represented and women leading in those sectors. We have 100 bilateral councils in about 90 countries over the world, so that we can do business globally, have business to business connections. And of course, we have these at the state level, at the city level, at the regional level, at the national level. We have just today launched the Banking and Credit Council of the Wiki, so that women who want access to lending, anything about credit finance, can have a one-stop place to ask and get answered all their needs. Ma'am, just to conclude, I'd like to say, I remember your beautiful quote at the Women Economic Forum in Goa, when you said, every working woman should make another woman a working woman. I think we are on that path. We are energizing the business women and the entrepreneurs to become leaders in their community and empower and inspire other women to join the workforce. Thank you very much, ma'am. I now invite you to address us all.
You are all amazing. I just don't know what I want to learn from you. You listening to me? I want to listen to you. You are all brilliant yourself. You are much ahead of me. Your task is much more complex than me. Therefore, the grass looks greener the other side. But I must tell you, you are all legends in your own ways. I want to thank Manjula, the president of the Eastern region. I've tweeted all of you. I've already got to it, my tweet and see. So Manjula, Rajiv Maheshwari ji, thank you, President CCC. And then we have Harbin. Arora, brilliant. I mean, I've seen you, all of you, so many after so long. Wo aapki shakal wahi hai abhi bhi. Kahi main pehchan pa rahi.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bahut maza aa raha hai aapko dekh ke.
Thank you.
And Indu, Indu, I haven't met, but I see Indu there, Indu Gandhi.
And you were there for
and I see single, Neha single.
She made the video, ma'am.
Neha, you made the video?
Yes, ma'am.
So nice of you, so grateful.
I hope you liked it.
My colleague Asha was going to keep it and now going to trade it around.
Yeah, sure. Sure, it's a gift for you, ma'am.
तुम पहले लिख के भेज दो, नहीं तो बाद में कहोगे नहीं दिया था.
No, I don't want to, ma'am,
but it's a gift for ma'am, baby, from my side. So wonderful, that's so sweet of you indeed.
Thank you.
It oozes, it's, you know what you're doing, you're oozing, you're sending me so much of love, so much of care, so much needed at the moment, because we're all closeted. Even Raj Nivas, you were saying, Harli was saying it's opened up. No, ab phir se band ho gaya. Woh COVID ne band kar diya.
Yeah.
Amne iski har khidki khol di thi, usne sab band kar diya. So things have changed so much. Give me 1 minute. So are you all at different places? Calcutta, Bombay, everywhere, Delhi? Alag
Delhi.
My God. Imagine if we were, we would have all been hugging each other had I come to your event. All right, I have your questions. I'll come back to you. But you are all very brilliant. And I'm very happy to, when Harleen said that you're doing regular workshops. I think that's your key. The fact that you're doing workshops, I would suggest keep doing any time the Prime Minister announces a policy. It's economic policy, social policy, labor policy, farm policy, financial policy. You should call for a workshop. I think that's your key because you're right at the top of the world. And the more knowledgeable you are, the better. I think you really need a glass every day. You women entrepreneurs and at the top of the business community. I think a weekly, if you're not having a weekly virtual class of a particular announcement of the policy of the week. And the more you do together virtually, the better. And contribute your views to the mygovernment.in, sending letters to the Prime Minister, the final, your views. Because you see, you are very uniquely placed. Therefore, you have practical knowledge. You've also got the family experience. You've got to also got hands-on experience. And also, you must dissect the policy completely. All of you need to be authorities in your respective fields. And then you can become a common faculty. I've noticed this is the strength. The more you know, the more you will be productive in your economic arenas. So I think you need to declare the subject of the week, and it's a virtual class is a must. If you don't do it weekly, do you?
We, ma'am, we do our councils. As I said, there are different. We have 8,000 office bearers who are part of different councils, and they do different. But I have to go and see whether it's happening every week. It's definitely happening very frequently, but I will now make sure that it happens systematically every week.
Harbin, I think what I have an idea for you is. That what I think, I'm just thinking with you, is that because you see you've put me on this, that we do workshops. I'm so happy about this banking workshop you're having. First of all, listen to the 8 a.m. radio news. All of you should listen, because whatever the cabinet decides in new policy comes in the 8 o'clock to 8:30 Hindi and 8:30 to 9 English. If you get into this habit of listening to the news, you will pick up the new policy, and the new policy will impact somebody of your commerce, because you are across all disciplines and you need to listen to each other, because they're interconnected policies, and there are social welfare policies, there are subsidy policies, there are incentive policies. I think you need to first of all understand the policy and then read editorials. One or two, three editorials or any magazine analysis, which you should also read, so that you can form your views and have a discussion. I think you should have a weekly subject, and it's no harm knowing if you're not in the finance, but you are in the social sector or in the manufacturing sector or in the marketing sector or the technology sector, because they're interconnected. So if you want to be at the top of the World Economic Forum as speakers, or as very intelligent participant, you need to invest into learning every week, and you must announce. And it's called attendance compulsory. Maheshwari sahab, main theek bol rahi hu? Mic on karo.
Haan ji, aap ekdam sahi keh rahi hai. Roz news sunni chahiye. It keeps you abreast of what's happening in Delhi and with current affairs.
That's right.
Absolutely. और मैं तो सुनता हूँ।
बिल्कुल, देखा ये सब करते हैं, ये तभी आगे हैं। If, अगर हमको we have to be progressive, we will have to be up to date in our news and analysis. I'm only giving you news, but you know what? If you listen to the news and you can while you're dressing, you're bathing, you can switch on the radio. It's a radio, and that means it's your my iPhone. You put on the AIR, put on the AIR radio, switch it on. So while you're bathing, you're dressing up, you can catch the news. So you even brushing your teeth, or even cooking. Or ironing, or sending the child home. You can do, listen. Neeti, 1 second. Just give me a moment. Anything urgent? Give me one moment. So may I suggest that, acha, now when I talked about the news, then 9 o'clock after that, there is the, like for instance yesterday, there's an MOU signed with Vietnam. What has been signed with Vietnam? It comes at 9 o'clock news. 9 o'clock ke baad, there's a 5 minutes program where a journalist interviews on the current affair. So there's an analysis of the subject of the current affair. Shut the news. Okay? There's an analysis. So news, you can listen to English news 8:30 to 9. And listen to that current affair. Then at 9 p.m. again. So that means while you are on the move, you can use your iPhone AIR. Look, every evening television debates don't give you much because they are so very sometimes pressure creating. They pressure because there's so much of conflict in those debates that you want to switch off, or sometimes you want to get away, or you want to put it on silent. But this you don't want to be silent. Because there's no pressure. So I would say, number one, women in business must stay up to date with the latest current news. And the cheapest and the fastest way is the morning radio news. Number one. Number two, while bathing or otherwise, switch on the BBC. Radio. Radio again. Again, you will have the ear. So while you're using your hands or doing dressing up, etc., listen to the BBC news. That means you are doing multi-news inputs. Or switch on the CNN. So have these applications in your on your iPhone and switch on BBC, switch on CNN and switch on radio. These are three very vital sources of information for all of you. What is cabinet deciding? And then PIB news. If you want to go to the internet, go to PIB. Press Information Bureau. Press Information Bureau gives you every day the latest announcements by the cabinet ministers. So you will get to know the policy changes. For you, being up to date is the real economic strength. And then sharing it. And then they will, the person who is the expert in this will say, nahi nahi, isse pehle ye tha, iska matlab ye hai, iska ye linked hai. So aap aapas mein, you start connecting the dots. I can tell you, ye mahina karke dekho, aapke aadmi log aapko sunna chahenge. Men will like to listen to you because you know more than them, because you will have probably spent more quality time in getting the maximum out of the minimum time in the right source. These are my sources of information. I am not in business and but I know about what's happening because I listen to the news and I know about the economic policies. I know about the agriculture debates. I'm aware of the special boosts which were given by Madam Finance Minister. So I've kept myself abreast. Similarly, what is happening on the BBC front, I've kept myself abreast. Though this is not necessary for me, it's important for me to know as a citizen of India and as a global citizen what's happening. And then there's a business world. So you need to go to the business channel. If you have to see a channel, listen to the political and other news here, but watch the business channel. The CNBC. So listen to those channels. Then you are thinking about your business, you're getting ideas, and you get a new innovation, and you will start coming up with better skills. I think your stage is of constant learning, challenging your knowledge and keep taking it forward. Like in my case, being administratively on rules and regulations, being up to date in judgments of the court so that I can apply those rules and judgments, that's for me. For you, it's policies, announcements, budgetary statements. So, though this is not in my mind to talk to you, but Arvind, you triggered this thinking for me that how do I, what is it I contribute? Go ahead.
I just wanted to thank you. I know it's coming straight from your heart because you truly want the women to flourish, and you are speaking straight from your experience because you have been in this world where we know that there is an unequal, you know, we need more women there, and you know exactly how to, you know, the bridge that gap and have gender parity at all levels. Is we must come across as equals in knowledge, and wherever we have the sector experts who are leading the councils, with council members who are sector experts, who are already doing within their councils this work, we will now have a focus that they may also share it with the other councils and have a mechanism of knowledge sharing between the 154 councils which represent almost every aspect of economy and society.
Great. And call this the expert of that subject. Call the expert of that subject in the workshop. You invite them. So you can have the subject of the week, the virtual subject of the week, where the expert is also called and is asked a Q&A. All are updated. You will see, you will grow and grow and grow. At least knowledge and information. How you want to use it is your choice. That's choices to be making. But how will you make choices if you do not give yourself choices? You have to put yourself into the race to give yourself choices. So otherwise there is no choice, you are okay. But looking at no choice is also a choice. Not taking anything more is also a choice. Because your level has come and say, I don't want anything more, I'm more happy with this. It's a very important choice to make. When to hang up your boots, it's a very important choice to make. When you exit batting, it's a choice to make. But that basically means you are always clearly knowing what you want, how much you want, why do you want, how do you want, from where do you get. All these then will make you think ahead. So I think you are at a very unique position. Take your level every day a little higher by reading Economic Times editorials. Editorials of reading Economic Times should be a habit. That way you'll get every different subject, and then when you're talking with each other, you will be able to contribute. So seeing you where you are today, this is what I think I can make it as a very important opening statement. And that's what Fiki could do, PhD should do, ASSOCHAM should do, you do, everybody should do. Where women are involved, Inner Wheeler should do, Rotary should do, where women are into entrepreneurship. So that when you are together, you talk business also. While you talk other things, you talk business. That's what men do. Actually, men start networks through these lunches and dinners because they're talking business. And they know the rest linkages. And they know who to contact to. They are a proper network. Because they're informed. Or unme se leadership uski nikalti jisko zyada pata hai. I think you must be one of them as well. While you're amongst your women, you need to be also part there and then participate in those conversations. And you should be the mastery of your own profession. Mastery. The first M of any success is mastery. Second M is membership of a community. Third is mobility. The three M's of success are mastery, mobility and membership of a community. You are already member of a community, sit as you are. You are already mobile because you are into business community. All you now need is mastery. The three M's of success are the three: mastery, mobility and membership of a community. But in the membership of the community, how do you raise your mastery? How do you raise mobility? How do you raise the quality of membership? right? Okay, yours now. I've said enough. Your mic's on. Manjula, your mic.
Yes, Kiranji, we have a few questions. That was lovely. It's so motivating. I think we should all follow whatever instructions you have given us. And we will pakka se take care with Harbinji's guidance. We are going to take this forward.
Yeah.
Yes, we have received a few questions from our members.
Okay.
The first one is from Rajiv Maheshwari himself only. With emphasis on women's empowerment by our Prime Minister, Honorable Narendra Modi ji, what in your opinion are the important areas where women can play a significant role to make India into a $5 trillion economy? I would like to have your views on that.
Every woman should realize her own potential.
That's true.
It does not matter where she is. Realize your own potential. If you are a very good mother at heart, realize your potential making a great home and giving great character building to your children if you want to be a mother at home. But if you are a business and an entrepreneur, then realize your potential, which means you have to continue to self-goad, self-engineer. So that's what the Prime Minister is saying. Apne aapko under nahi karo, apne aapko dabao mat, apna potential ko realize karo. और उस पोटेंशियल रियलाइज करने के लिए मेहनत करनी पड़ेगी. अगर आप चाहते हो, अगर आप मेहनत करना करने के काबिल हो, अगर आप सोचते नहीं मेरी ये लेवल है और मैं इससे संतुष्ट हूँ, तो फिर इंजॉय करो. फिर मतलब यह है कि मुझे आई मस्ट इंजॉय डूइंग वॉट एवर आई डू एंड दैट शुड बी माई चॉइस, नॉट कंपल्शन. समबडी शुड नॉट टेल मी एंड ड्राइव मी लाइक अ स्लेव. आई शुड नेवर बी स्लेव ड्रिवन, नॉट स्लेव ड्रिवन, सेल्फ ड्रिवन.
So you have to come out of your comfort zone.
Absolutely.
So Rajivji, your question has been
But
answered.
Then you have to make a choice to cut out of comfort zone, not by pain. You
yes.
have to make a choice, make it a joyful comfort.
Yeah.
I don't want anybody, why should we suffer our lives? Why? We should live our lives. Why should we suffer our lives? And number two, that will happen only when we stop comparing with each other. वो ज़्यादा अमीर है मेरे से, वो ज़्यादा है, वो ज़्यादा सुंदर है, उसका बड़ा प्लस. Stop comparing. हम एवरीबडी इज यूनिक इन देयर ओन वे एंड हैव अ सेंस ऑफ सेल्फ कंटेंटमेंट. सो कंफर्ट जोन क्योंकि आई वांट दिस, नॉट दैट आई बिकॉज आई वांट टू बी लाइक देम, देन यू आर नेवर कंपेरेबल. तो फिर तो आपका कुछ लिमिट ही नहीं है, यू नेवर बी सैटिस्फाइड. अगर आप थोड़े में खुश हो, लेकिन खुश हो, देन यू आर द रिचेस्ट. सो नो कंपेरिजन, नो कॉम्पिटिशन, कॉम्पिटिशन विद योर ओन सेल्फ. I want to do better. And then prepare yourself. So it's not comfort zone, it's a preparation. So you prepare accordingly. Prepare. It's a preparation every day by doing that extra. You must live your lives enjoyably, joyfully. Bhagwan ne sab kuch agar diya hai, to ye jiyo isko. Live your life. Go ahead. Next one.
Okay. So our next question is, a safer society can facilitate more women to confidently step out of their dream journey. What steps can be taken to improve women's safety?
Look, women's safety is directly linked with good administration. Where there's good administration, good policing, good law and order, there will be, and good enforcement of criminal justice system, women will certainly feel more safe. So it is directly beyond you a little, but where is it not so much beyond you is where you find areas and gaping holes of in administration. You must point out as an organization. So that means you can regularly write to the concern, because you are into a position to write as an organization. That's what organizational strength gives you. But if you also become an onlooker or indifferent, then you are not realizing your potential. So whether it's an economic policy, whether it's a social issue, you must have a voice to write. So therefore, the organization of Wiki should take up causes which it impacting women's safety. Supposing a particular law or a functioning is not good, without blaming or complaining, you should say, this is what we're finding deficient, we would like to see. So you need to make a contribution, point out, and find out the avenues, who to work with. And maybe go as deputations, go as forums, take up causes. It's not agitation, it's a statement. And sometimes do a press release that we have expressed our concern. You're not being political, you're being socially responsible. So put your, choose your words carefully without earning hostility.
You were the one who enabled women to march shoulder to shoulder with men and to stand up for their rights. So this is how we have to just move on. Yeah, the next third question is, secret of your physical and mental strength that keeps you going from one success to another. One of our members wants to know.
It is not my effort, it is divine guidance. If I say I am doing it, I am wrong. I think I am getting it done. Somebody is a divine force within me which is guiding me. I see a guidance. Where does a good thought come from? Where did this invitation come from? Did I ask you to invite me? It has come. A thought came to you. Who gave you that thought? Did you think that thought? You must believe in this. Somewhere certain things are coming as guidance. I am going by guidance, but I am responding to the guidance. I am not resisting the guidance. So if the guidance is to work hard, I am working hard. That is guidance, and I am going. Now if I am saying I am working hard, well, maybe somebody is making me work hard. Who knows? So I think there is an invisible hand in our lives. We just have to let it flow. Allow it to flow, saying I am willing to take that flow. Take that flow and flow with it.
That's true. So to achieve your dreams, you have to really work tirelessly and believe in him, right?
Believing in some divine guidance. Why is this happening? Why am I getting this? There's a reason. Good or bad, let me tell you that. Good or bad. So they will say, well, I didn't earn it. Well, say, I want you to suffer it, suffer it. If I have given you joy, I have given you sorrow, suffer it. It's a part of life. So I think you have to take life as it comes and respond to it with the best of your wisdom and ability. Apply your own mind. I'm not saying laid back. But again, it's a mystery. Who's giving you the strength to respond to it? So all you have to do is continue to be positive and continue to give your best. Whether you're getting the best to be done or you're giving it, it's a mystery. But keep doing your best.
So that's a positive energy that is within you.
Yes.
I think the next question relates to this only. How do you balance your professional...
Work is important. What is important on which day is very, very important to continue to make the right choices. And of course, developing support systems. Because if you want to gain your own time, you pay for your support system, which means you delegate what you can pay for. And in India, we are very blessed. We can pay for. Go to America, you cannot get anybody at any cost to pay, to be even paid for. You have to do all those things yourself. The way women can organize here, just cannot do this overseas as much. They can do only one thing. And look at the problem they have. They don't even get a nanny. They do not get any support system. And the moment they get into motherhood, they are into serious time pressures. And men walk away. Their men walk away. Many times they walk away. Many times, not all. I think 50-50. So what do they do left with children? So I would think that as women, we must continue to buy time, buy energy, and then use our energy best where we should, and spend where we can, earn time where we can, so that we do the best with whatever we have. So I would think balancing professional personal life is also ensuring your family is under comfort. Pay for it. Everybody should be comfortable. Therefore, if you have the money, pay for it. Spend on it and enjoy the time.
So support system is the keynote. As I had heard you in Fikki also, you spoke about your mom being your support system.
Yes, mommy was a, yes, but I made sure my mom's life was comfortable too.
Yes.
If my mommy is supporting me, does mommy have support system? Yes. So mommy also enjoyed the support system.
Yeah.
I spent for it. I make sure I spend for my support system my mother has. She has a driver, she has a vehicle, she has a cook, she has somebody to clean, and she has a nanny to look after my... I paid for it. My service paid for it, and I also paid for it. So mommy was not... Mommy was mommy, but enjoys being home. So therefore, mommy ka rehna hi bahut badi blessing hai ghar mein.
Kiran ji, the next question is, many women have been inspired by seeing you having achieved so much in various fields. What keeps you motivated and how do you cross the hurdles on your way? There have been many hurdles on your way, yes. We've been going through the news, so we have been seeing since years. So we would like to hear from you, what were the hurdles and how did you overcome them?
Very simple. It's a very simple mantra. I read a Tibetan monk says every time, every morning when I get up, I put my feet on ground. He says, I ask myself, do I want my day heaven as hell or hell? And he says, I choose heaven. The moment you choose heaven, will you be negative? No. So, chabhi negative thought aayegi, tumko ko, oh, maine to, I have chosen heaven. Where is the negative coming from? Because negative is hell. So every time, in many times while bathing, if a negative thought or a sad thought comes in my mind, I say, oh, heaven, 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 heaven. It comes back. I think that's the secret, is constantly choosing positive thoughts in your mind and driving the negative out and finding solutions for issues. So always choose heaven every morning and cut out hell.
That's great.
So it's a mantra.
Yes, that's a good mantra. We are all going to follow that. Okay, Kiranji, the next question is, what opportunities do women have in their hands to earn and create wealth?
I told you the secret in the beginning.
Yes.
Do that.
So this has been answered. The next question comes up as, what strategy to adopt in these unprecedented times to stay safe but not in fear?
Is,
I think Puducherry has been taking good care about this COVID pandemic, and I was just reading today in your message that very few pandemic cases are there now, taking proper care. So I would like to, we would like to hear from
you. You see, it depends on where you are. As an administrator, you have a set of responsibilities. As a CEO or as a manager of a company, you have your home and other staff, right? So it all depends where. If you are an organizational president, you have another role. So you have roles to play. And in those roles, you have to identify what are the areas of safety you need to take care of these, whether it's financial net, whether it's a social net, whether it's an entrepreneurial net, whether it's your staff resources. So I think we all have our so many caps which we wear. It's important that we assess reality and then start working on them so that everybody is safe. That's why we're working from home. The fact is that we're working from home is basically we are all looking after each other's safety net. That you don't come, I don't come, I don't infect you, you don't infect me. And that if you come, we sit in social distance. That's where we are keeping ourselves safe, right? These are the, and then you have also regularly, constantly training, you constantly upgrading so that economic employment remains and you're not laying off people so much. It's again economic safety. Children's safety is you learn, you're not going to school, you learn from school, from home, and that you are guiding them. You're accepting certain realities of life. I think that's a point, is how do you stay safe and you say no to many invitations. If certain things are of sadness and joy are coming, you have the courage to say, I think it's not good for us to come, or it's not the right thing to do. So it's not, I'm emotional, ho gayi, main chali gayi, aur main phas ke aa gayi, mujhe wo COVID ho gaya. नहीं जा सकती तो नहीं जा सकती, ये नहीं मतलब कि मैं आपके साथ नहीं हूँ. सो बोथ द थिंग्स यू हैव टू कॉन्स्टेंटली एवेलुएट, विल आई बी सेफ वेर एवर आई एम गोइंग टूडे. आई थिंक वी हैव टू स्पेंड 2021 ऑल्सो विद लॉट ऑफ प्रिकॉशन. 21 विल नीड सेम काइंड ऑफ सिक्योरिटी, सेम काइंड ऑफ 3S सेफ्टी, सेफ डिस्टेंस एंड सैनिटेशन, मास्किंग. वी मस्ट कॉन्स्टेंटली बी केयरफुल that we make no take no risk. That's why virtual is going to be your way. Do not unnecessarily cancel and go for lunches and dinners. Stick to virtual. You can even have virtual dinner together, you can have virtual lunch together. Sab jane khao, baat bhi karo, khao, maza aayega.
Thank you always.
Nice, finish it.
Thank you. Said that about mask, that let your mask be your medicine.
Yeah.
Let your mask
correct.
Medicine.
Correct.
Those are your words.
Yes.
And you have been giving virtual story reading sessions with children aged 10 to 16 every week.
Yeah.
And you teach them good values and how to become better citizens of the country.
Yeah.
That's remarkable. I mean, with your type of work where you are so busy with your own styles and your own administrations, but still you give time to those children.
I love children. I love children, and it's our responsibility to pass on whatever we have.
So lastly and finally, what advice would you give to our members to achieve their goals? Though you have spoken much about it, but we would like to hear in
I think words. It's an organic growth of oneself. It's an organic growth, psychological growth, social growth, economic growth, family growth. I think it's an overall organic. It's being organic, looking after every aspect of human mind, whether it's mind, body, soul. So when you look at growth economically, I think that's what, not goal is not one, ki aaj maine yahan se wahan jana hai, to maine itna kamana hai. I think it's organic, it's holistic growth. If you are looking at holistically, you achieve success. In the end, what is our goal? Is that we want to be happy and healthy. And I think first going to be challenges to remain healthy. Happiness gives you health and health gives you happiness. I think the first goal of everybody should be maintain good health, both mental and physical. If you maintain mental and physical health, then we all know what to do. But we cannot be psychologically weaker and physically dependent. So if we can be physically and healthy, I think that should be the priority of individually and collectively. If we do that, we have achieved it. And then we are multiplied. After all, time is there for investment. You will invest time into growth. But at the moment, health comes first. Along with health will come wealth and happiness. But with health, without with health, health may not come. You may have it's like people, Italy was running out of oxygen. And somebody said, I had all the money, I had all the air all my life. I never realized everything was so free. Italy, remember in the peak time, ran out of oxygen cylinders at the beds, and they had to choose between lives. Kisko cylinder they? In Italy, beds, people had to choose between citizens, who do they give the oxygen cylinder to? So oxygen, which was free, now was in demand and in scarcity. So what I would say is, health is wealth, not necessarily wealth is health, but you need the wealth to maintain your good health so that you eat well, you live well, and you live comfortably.
Yes, that was such a lot of learning from you, Dr. Bedi. Now I would invite our Vicky Vice President, Indu Gandhi, to give the formal vote of thanks.
Indu is the Vice Thank President. You.
Yes.
Kiranji, we are really, I'm at a loss of words. There's so much we've learned today, and there's so much that we all are going to take back with us from you. Thank you so, so much for sharing your insights, thoughts and knowledge. And yes, knowledge is the path to success. And we shall always remember the 3 M's of success. Thank you so much for taking out time from your very busy schedule for us.
Thank you.
I would also like to thank Dr. Harbin Arora, who has always been a great motivation. And we are really, really very proud to be a part of her.
The founder.
Raji, for she has always been a great support and a great guidance to us. I would like to take the opportunity to thank Rajiv Maheshwari ji, President, and Shailja Mehta ji, Senior VP of Calcutta Chamber of Commerce, for being our associate partners. A big thank you to Usha ji Agarwal for her guidance always. To the members of All Ladies League, Wiki, and Calcutta Chamber of Commerce for their presence, and of course all the other viewers who are with us today. To Neha Singhal for the beautiful creative and video which she's created, which is a gift to you from all of us, and I'm sure you remember us watching that too. Also Rishabh Pipalwa, IT, who is IT in charge, who has made this event without any glitches. Thank you so much, Rishabh ji, and a very big thank you to all the viewers. Again, a very big thank you, Kiran ji, for being with us. We have learned so much and made a note of all the points, and we promise you we shall live up to it. Thank you, and keep blessing us and guiding us.
See you again sometime. Absolutely. Thank you.
Absolutely. Thank you, madam. Thank you, madam.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Namaskar.
Thank you.
I'll join your Christmas event now.
Ah, lovely.